The next step of our tutorial is to open up the FLUENT solver and begin specifying boundary conditions on our problem. To open up the FLUENT solver, first come up into the project window and double-click Setup. When this pop-up dialog box is launched, we'll need to specify a couple of things. Under Options, we will first specify Double Precision, so click the checkbox. Next, come under Processing Options, and if you have the capabilities, click the Parallel Radio box, and you can specify the number of processes you want to run your machine with. After you specify these things, press OK, and FLUENT will launch. When I'm solving a problem in FLUENT, I like to look at the outline window and work my way down. In the problem setup, we're first going to work in general, which is the default open window. The first thing we're going to need to specify is the type of solver. We're currently defaulted at a pressure-based solver, but we're actually going to be using a density-based solver for this problem. So click the radio box next to density-based. The only other thing we need to change in this window is under 2D space, we need to click the radio box next to axis symmetric. So click the radio box. The next thing we're going to work on is the model. So under problem setup, come down to models and click it. First, we're going to double click energy. This will allow us to turn on the energy equation in our solver. So check the box next to energy equation and press OK. Next, we need to choose the type of viscous model we're going to use. It's defaulted to laminar, but we're actually going to use an inviscid model. So double-click viscous, and under model, click inviscid. Then press OK. Next, we're going to specify the material for our simulation. So under problem setup, click materials. In materials, we're going to be specifying the fluid first. So under materials, under fluid, click air. Double click it. This will open up the create edit materials window. Under density, we're actually going to be using an ideal gas case. So under the drop-down box, look for and click Ideal Gas. This will bring up the ideal gas conditions for air. When you have done that, press Change Create, and then close the box. Next, we're going to specify the boundary conditions. So under Problem Setup, come up here to Boundary Conditions and click it. We'll start at the top and work our way down. The first zone is the axis, so click on axis, and we'll see that the type has already defaulted to axis. This is good enough, so we'll keep moving. Next, click the nozzle wall. This zone is already defaulted to wall, so we don't need to do anything else there. Next, click outlet. The type has been specified as a pressure outlet, which is correct, but we still have to change a couple of things. So click Edit. We need to specify the gauge pressure. The gauge pressure was specified in the problem specification, and we need to type that in here. That value is 3738.9. When you've specified the gauge pressure, press OK. Finally, we need to specify the gauge pressure for the pressure inlet. So click Pressure Inlet, check that the type is indeed pressure inlet, and press edit. The gauge pressure we're going to be using for the simulation is actually atmospheric pressure. So enter in atmospheric pressure in pascals, which is 101325. Next, we need to specify the supersonic initial gauge pressure. This is an initial guess value for the static pressure. So we're going to enter that 99348. While we're in the pressure inlet window, also click on the thermal tab. we'll see that the temperature has defaulted to 300 Kelvin, which is also specified in our problem specification. So that's all set. So press OK. The last thing we need to do here is change the operating conditions. So click on operating conditions. The operating pressure we're actually going to use is 0 pascals. So enter that. When you have done so, press OK. The final step in the setup is to set the reference values. Under problem setup, click reference values. And we need to tell Fluent where to compute the reference values from. Under the dropbox, we want to use the pressure inlet. So click pressure inlet. These values will be used when computing non-dimensional numbers like drag coefficient and other things like that. That was the last step in the setup. We are now ready to set up the solver and then solve the equation.